I've had a lot of emails and texts and questions through the years. Captain Bill, tell us about your boats, and boats plural. I have the one that I've had the longest is my baby. It's called the Lucky Strike. And actually all my boats are called a Lucky Strike now, but I've had this boat 35 years. It was built in 1959. It's a wood boat built by the Daniels brothers in Fort Myers. The model is the West Coast Fisherman. It's a 26-foot center console inboard. Some people will say, well, it's the classic old-style Boca Grande boat. Yes, it is. That's what it was built for. Some of you may have seen the Morgan boat. The Morgan boat is a copy, a model of this. In fact, Johnny Morgan married into the Daniels family, and he later on made a 24-foot open center console boat like this. But this was built by the original, by the Daniels brothers, in 1959. I've had two or three motors in it. I've got a V8 350 marine power. That's the same as a Chevy or a Crusader block. When I bought this boat from a fellow named Augie Perigno in Miami many moons ago, it did not look like this at all. It did not look like this at all. I've restored this boat three times completely, and each time making little tweaks. And the original fellow that helped me with it was Bill Wiley. Bill was a boat builder from Long Island in New York and retired down in the Tarpon Springs Holiday area. And he originally helped me in the original rebuild. But through the years, Bill Graham and Courtney Ross at Ross Yacht have helped me maintain this boat and keep it in what's called Bristol condition. I try to keep it in Bristol condition. That's spotless. Doesn't always get spotless when you're fishing, but we try. It's got a lot of neat features to it. Got some varnished teak on it. Kind of gives it the old classic look. As I was rebuilding this boat, I wanted to keep the old classic look, and I think I have. One of the things the old-time boat builders got right is a lot of bait wells. Now, we don't have the fancy, back in those days, they didn't have the fancy pumps or anything like we've got today. So all the wells are through-hole wells. And I've got three of them in this boat. This one, that one in front, and I've got one over on the other side. And there's holes drilled through the bottom, and that's the way the circulation comes into the bait well. Through the years, I've since put another pump in there. When I get a lot of bait in there, I want to add some. I'll add the pump to it, or when I'm sitting at the marina waiting to pick up or something like that, I'll turn it on. But three bait wells, all on the floor, make it pretty handy, and I carry a lot of bait. This steering wheel is in the original location that it was. I mentioned that I wanted to keep the boat as original as possible and as classic looking as possible. The original steering wheel was right here, and so I left it. A lot of the steering wheels today now would come out of the console, but I left it right where it is. It's got the classic look, got the wheel wrapped in leather, another part of the old classic look, and then Bill Graham made this beautiful centerpiece for me. This is called a bezel. This and the gauge dials inside are all original, certainly not the original gauge. This is another part of the originality of the boat. These engine room vents, there's four of them. In all inboard boats, they have them. A lot of times you'll see them, they'll be the chrome over brass or the chrome over pot metal vents that just come in and help circulate the gas fumes and stuff out of the bilge. These are mahogany, and there's four of them, and they are exactly the same. The grain on all four of them is exactly the same. I've never seen them like it anywhere else before. Bill Wiley did that, and it really added a nice touch to the boat. The motor box in front of the console makes a seat, and two or three people can sit right there. These bunks on either side also are very comfortable. Under this one is storage all the way up. There's a shelf. So this underneath this is all storage. On the front of the port side is storage, and right underneath here is a porta potty. We just open the porta potty up, pull up the spray curtain, and drop the privacy curtain, and then they can go to the bathroom. And then this is a drawer for extra tackle. There's also storage up in front under the bow cap. Lots of storage up in there. It's where I keep my life jackets and all my safety gear. This is also storage in here. I keep cast nets. I've got four cast nets and buckets. I've also got some buoys and all my dock lines. So there's plenty of storage in this boat. As they, when they built this boat back in the day, they thought it out very nicely. One thing interesting about this boat is Zane Grey, the famous outdoorsman and author, he wanted to go up to Nova Scotia and try for a world record tuna on rod and reel. And Zane Grey commissioned the Daniels brothers to build him a boat, and they built him a 26-foot West Coast Fisherman, just like this. And he took it up to Nova Scotia and caught a number of bluefin tuna, some over 1,000 pounds, using a Daniels-made boat. Also, when he made his trip to Tahiti and all through the South Pacific, the boats that he took with him were Daniels-made boats. And when the Daniels brothers started their own boatyard, they originally with a company of the Williams brothers, I think Williams Boatyard, something like that. The Daniels brothers went out and started their own boatyard. There is good truth to the rumor that Zane Grey was their financial backer. But in fact, he did have two Daniels boats, West Coast Fishermen, just like this. When I first bought the boat, I did not have a tower. I used it mainly for tarpon fishing in Boca Grande Pass. And I had a bimini top over the center of the boat for shade. Later on, I put a tower on. I was doing a lot of beach fishing, and the tower offers a lot of shade, but still this piece up here, these cushions where everybody seemed to gravitate to, was in the sun. So we just put a little bimini top up above it like that, and we've got complete sunshade from the back, from the steering wheel actually all the way up to here. So the boat's very comfortable and easy to spend the day on the water.
Be sure to keep up with the latest news, picks, reports, and videos on all your favorite social networks.